The horror genre is a glorious, gory, and ghoulish corner of cinema, with its many subgenres offering up so many possibilities for brilliance. It also tends toward twists, which by their very nature and design can catch us all off guard. Well, not necessarily all of us. I'm Jess from What Culture. We've put together a list of 10 big horror movie reveals that you can spot early if you really look. Number 10. Jay kills his wife and child. Kill List. Focused on two former soldiers who take work as hitmen, Kill List has a sickening reveal waiting at its conclusion. Having had to take on a kill list of people known as the priest, the librarian, and the MP, Neil Maskell's Jay ends up finding himself surrounded by a cult who've threatened the life of his wife and child. At the behest of the cult, Jay has to kill one more target, as he's presented with the masked, cloaked hunchback. After a brutal fight in which he's the victor, it's then revealed to Jay that said hunchback was his wife, with their son strapped to her back. In terms of gut punches, they don't get much more jarring. When rewatching the movie, you get a clear indicator of this shocking twist, with a play fight scene showing Jay stabbing his wife while their son is on her back. Number 9. The Repeated Numbers – Ghost Stories. Andy Nyman plays Philip Goodman, a professor and TV presenter who specializes in debunking supposed paranormal activity. Goodman is encouraged by his childhood hero to delve into three particular cases. Upon doing so, the nuanced narrative of Ghost Stories ends with the reveal that none of these three cases are real, and that Nyman's character is actually in a comatose state of locked-in syndrome. The twist of the tale is that Philip was part of a bunch of kids who played a prank on a disabled boy that led to his death. Luring the youngster into an underground tunnel, Goodman and his pals set a task for their target to find a set of numbers in this dark locale. Only the final number of the pattern isn't there. The victim panicked, had an asthma attack, and died. This was all teased without us even knowing, as the numerical pattern from this torment is featured at several points throughout the movie. Number 8. Norma is a Stuffed Bird – Psycho. Throughout the 109-minute runtime of Hitch's 1960 offering, the legendary director utilizes the imagery of birds as a subtle motif for certain themes. The film also uses birds to slyly hint at the jaw-dropping reveal that Norma Bates' mother has been dead throughout the entire movie. As Norman sits chatting to the unsuspecting Marion Crane, he quells any concerns about his intense ma by informing Janet Leigh's character that his mother is as harmless as one of the stuffed birds on his office wall. Right then and there, Bates is giving a verbal wink that Norma is a deceased, dressed-up shell of her once-alive self. Additionally, the songbird scene dotted around Marion positioned her as prey for something bigger and badder. That's similarly indicated by Norman being framed by both peaceful and predatory birds in this scene, showing the dueling personalities of the Norman Bates character. Number 7. It Was Roy All Along – Friday the 13th, Part 5. With Tommy Jarvis last seen butchering Jason Voorhees to death at the close of the final chapter, he's a prime suspect when dead bodies start showing up left, right, and center. Similarly, the opening act brutal murder of chocolate enthusiast Joey by Vic throws up the possibility of the otherwise absent Vic as the person behind these plentiful corpses. Throw in a creepy voyeur, few crazed redneck neighbors, a lead female named Pam, and the fifth Friday picture had several candidates to be its killer. That's not even taking into account the possibility of Jason being back from the dead again. The reveal, of course, is that local paramedic Roy Burns was responsible for the carnage of a new chapter. It'd be explained how Roy was the father of one and the same Joey from the opening act, but seriously, surely anyone paying early attention would have picked up on that. Random background actor with a crazy-eyed fade-to-black scene when picking up Joey's body? That was a huge giveaway. Number 6. The period-specific references. Final Destination 5. Delivered as a straight-up sequel, seemingly taking place in and around the timeline of its release in 2011, the major head spinner of Final Destination 5 is that it was actually a prequel picture, with the film's close dovetailing into the opening airplane explosion of the very first movie. To give credit where credit's due, this was quite the genius swerve, yet it was a swerve that the film had actually suggested far, far earlier than anyone had realized. One particular tease was the Olivia character being compared to singer Lisa Loeb. Loeb shot to global stardom in 94 with her Stay single, then sold a bunch of records for the years leading up to the 2000 release of the first Final Destination. Even before this, Final Destination 5 featured an early act announcement for all pages to be turned off. Then there was the main character Sam, detailing how he wanted to intern at the upmarket Le Café Miro, which was the same restaurant three of the first film's characters dine in. Number 5. The Best Friend Did It – Urban Legend. 1998's Urban Legend is a movie that wasn't shy about hiding its ultimate reveal. The only caveat, though, is that you had to be versed in Latin to be able to get an early inkling on how things would play out by the time the movie rolled to a close. The action of this Jamie Blanc's helmed effort takes place across the campus of the fictional Pendleton University. And for those paying attention and with the ability to read Latin, the logo and motto of Pendleton points the finger of suspicion directly at Rebecca Gayhart's Brenda Bates. Pendleton's motto reads, Amicum Optimum Factum, which translates as the best friend did it. Of course, the main protagonist of Urban Legend is Alicia Witt's Natalie. Who's Natalie's best bud? Why, it's Brenda. Considering that the Amicum Optimum Factum motto is on loud and proud view from the opening moments of the film, Urban Legend was giving away its massive twist right in front of our faces. Number 4. Explosive Foreshadowing. Jaws. Not a reveal per se, but the closing battle of Jaws was foreshadowed barely 20 minutes into the movie. There with Chief Brody reading up on the toothy terrors of the ocean, there's a blink and you'll miss it image in Brody's book that depicts a shark chewing on an air canister. Not only did Brody's reading hint at the finale of Jaws, it also actually hinted at the finale of Jaws 2. There the beast of the sequel is taken down after Roy Scheider's chief lulls the great white into taking a bite out of an electrical cable. How was the ending of the sequel teased in the very first film? That's because Brody also reads a page about how sharks are attracted to rhythmic vibrations, which Brody clearly has in his mind when he bashes said electrical cable and lures the monstrous threat of Jaws 2 to its ultimate demise. Number 3. The Alien Light. Honeymoon. Rose Leslie plays newlywed Bee, who we see enjoying an idyllic remote honeymoon with her hubby Paul. Barely do the couple have time to get settled into their cabin in the woods before things take a worrying turn for Bee. After Paul finds his wife naked and confused in the woods in the middle of the night, it becomes apparent that Bee has been through something. She becomes distant from her hubby, she forgets how to do basic tasks, and eventually she gives birth to a strange creature. The ultimate reveal of the movie is that she was abducted and impregnated by aliens when Paul had discovered her. An early nod towards this reveal can be found in the opening act. As Paul and Bee lay sleeping in bed, a light shines on the face of Leslie's character, with that light being from an alien presence, looking to carry out the familiar, typical abduction seen in so many other alien-driven movies. Number 2. An Ironic Costume. Trick or Treat. In a fun play on the fabled fame, Michael Dougherty's Trick or Treat is almost brazen in how it flaunts one of its big reveals. As part of this brilliant 2007 anthology offering, the surprise party tale sees Anna Paquin's Laurie taking center stage. A shy, unassuming sort, Laurie has dressed up as Little Red Riding Hood for Halloween, which when looking back at the film was a giant red flag as to what shock lay waiting around the corner. Having been stalked by a mysterious masked figure, the tables are turned on this poor fool, as the hunter becomes the hunted. That's due to the big swerve of this segment being that Laurie is actually a werewolf. Rather than Little Red Riding Hood being tormented by the big bad wolf, Laurie is positioned in both of these particular roles. And the reveal of this was slapping us all across the face from the moment the character was seen decked out in the familiar red getup. Number 1. Jigsaw's Trap Sketches. Saw. Of course, we all know that the overarching big bad of the Saw franchise is John Kramer, aka the Jigsaw Killer. But at a first watch of the original Saw, everyone was left shocked when a totally dead body stood up at the film's close and revealed himself as a maniacal mastermind. For Jigsaw, his MO is that he wants people to realize how precious life really is. And to do that, he puts them in situations where they're pushed to their absolute limits in terms of what lengths they'll go to in order to stay alive. If you were one of those paying eagerly attention though, then you'd have picked up on the fact that there certainly was something going on with John Kramer. That's due to how the hospitalized Kramer was spotted earlier in the movie, with a bedside doodle of what was the franchise's iconic reverse bear trap device. Let me know down in that comment section which big horror movie reveal is your favorite and which ones you managed to spot early. As always, I've been Jess from What Culture. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. You can come say hi to me on my Twitter where I'm at Jess McDonald, but make sure you stay tuned to us here for plenty more content.